If you ever plan to motor west, travel my way, take the highway, that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66. It winds from Chicago to LA, more than 2,000 miles all the way. Get your kicks on Route 66.
We used to visit my grandmother on Christmas and New Year's. My dad took us out of Catholic school for a couple of weeks, and he got 30 days from the steel mill. He was a steel worker. I'm a son of a steel worker. So we visit my grandmother every year around Christmas and New Year's. And then when we went back to Chicago on the old Route 66, at that time, the old Route 66, all we talk about at dinner time is how to come of going west. My name is Ruben Pardo. I like going up and down. I was born to go up and down, and I like the public. I've been doing it for so many years that I'm used to it. It's like my second home. I have been in this building 18 and a half years, coming on Valentine's Day. And I have to make sure that the elevator is level with the floor so people will not fall down. I have a steering wheel inside there, like you have your steering wheel in the car. And I have to know how to level the elevator with the floor because it's not automatic. Everything is manual here. And these doors right here, they're heavy steel. You have to have a strong arm. I'm a right arm guy. And I think with all these doors, like gymnastics, this is in competition with my right hand is getting competition with my left, because this one, I have to close these doors and open it, and they're very heavy. I love to go fast. It's been inside of me as long as I can remember. Once in a while, a woman, I tell her to face with her back, so her emotions will not take over. And I try to be considerate with everybody, because I consider myself a professional when it deals with the public. I have one son of going close to 13 years old, and I have one wife and three cats. We believe in independence. We like, our favorite word in the encyclopedia is freedom. Did that come out?
I don't know.
Do I dream? Yes, I dream a lot. In fact, sometimes I'm astounded to myself, because some of my dreams, I will consider them from the future. One time I had this dream, it seems like a heaven, and I was very emotional. Well, when I got out of the elevator, everything was a lot of light. It was an eternal road, like never finish. I could hardly see. I even went like this. And I saw somebody behind the light, a man with a beard. And he told me, it's not your time. I'm going to send you back. And I didn't know what he was talking about. and then, like I said before, the alarm sounded. And I woke up, and then I realized where he sent me back to. Like right now, the bell's ringing in the elevator, and it woke me up right now. So excuse me. I'll be right back. The moment the person comes into the elevator, then I shut the doors and I reset it. There's a button here that resets it. That means I already had picked up the person. It's inside my elevator. This is to go down. It goes slow. This interlocks. And to go up, you have to push it the opposite way, and it goes faster. You only have two speeds, but it's all a matter of control in your right hand. We have this art gallery, and whenever they invite movie stars, I'm lucky. I'm very privileged and very lucky because I see him next to me, and I don't have to pay to see him. In general, I think movie stars are wonderful because they put long hours and they're very dedicated to the profession. And it's something like me. I have to be an actor when I go up and down. I have a lot of faith in this building, which was built in 1929, and it was the tallest high-rise back in that year. An earthquake can come any place in the world, and if it's your turn, you're gone. And when it's my turn, I'm gonna take it like a man. You're not supposed to think about the negative perspectives. I'm a positive all the way, a positive person all the way. See what I mean? If God wills it, I'm gonna die in the elevator. But that's not the point. The point is, do you enjoy your life? Are you dedicated to what you are doing? See, that's what you have to ask yourself that. If you cannot answer that, then you better find yourself another career. Goodbye, wonderful people, from a professional elevator operator. For all the elevator operators of the world, bye!
Get your kicks on Route 66.